Welcome to the .NET MAUI Switch Control Tutorial. The Syncfusion .NET MAUI Switch allows you to toggle an item on and off and provides an optional indeterminate state. In this video, I will show you how to add a .NET MAUI Switch control to your .NET MAUI application. I will demonstrate how a switch operates programmatically and show its different states. I will also show you how to customize the track and thumb appearance. Before you begin, ensure you have installed the latest version of Visual Studio 2022 with the required .NET MAUI workload. You should also have one of the .NET SDKs installed on your machine. After installing the necessary tools, launch Visual Studio 2022 and click Create a New Project from the dashboard. From the list of project templates, select the .NET MAUI application. Then, give the project name and location. Next, create a project with the .NET 8.0 framework. Now, the default application is ready to use. Before moving forward, let me take a quick detour to set up the application's environment. I select the Android emulators from this list to see the output in the Pixel 5 emulator. Next, I'll run the application to show you the default output. The application compiles the default code, so wait for a few seconds. Now, the application's home page is displayed. Next, let me show you how to incorporate this switch control into this application. I need to install the Syncfusion MAUI Buttons NuGet package, so I open the NuGet package manager and switch to the Browse tab. I search for the Syncfusion MAUI Buttons package, select it, and install it in my project. After the package is installed, I need to register the handler for the Syncfusion core to map the cross-platform control API to the native view API. I open the MAUI program CS file and add the Syncfusion MAUI core hosting namespace. Then register the Syncfusion core handler by adding the configure Syncfusion core method. Registering a trial license key is necessary to use the Syncfusion MAUI controls. So, I open the appsaml cs file and add the register license method with a trial license key. To find out where to generate it, please refer to the instructions link in the description below. Next, I navigate to the main page XAML to initialize the control. I'll remove the default code from the content page section and import the Syncfusion MAUI buttons namespace. Next, I initialize the MAUI switch control. You can see the switch control in the center of the emulator. You can toggle it on or off by tapping it. To programmatically turn on the switch, set the isOn property to true. By default, it is set to false. See, the switch is now on. Next, let me show you the different states of the switch control, on, off, and indeterminate. For example, this can be seen when managing notification settings for the listed apps on mobile devices. To demonstrate this, I'll add a frame control and set its width to 350 and height to 200. Inside the frame, add a vertical stack layout and customize its padding. Within this layout, add a grid layout with two columns. In the first column, I place a label and set its text to all apps. Then, customize its vertical text alignment, font size, and font attributes properties. In the second column, I insert a switch control and set its name to all apps, horizontal options to center. This switch enables users to toggle the notification settings for all listed apps. Similarly, I add switches for YouTube, Gmail, and Twitter apps, allowing users to manage their notification settings individually for each app. Finally, define the state changed event for the all apps switch with a new event handler method. This event triggers once the switch state is changed. Next, I define the state changed event for the Gmail app with another new event handler method, and similarly, define the state changed event for Twitter and YouTube with the Gmail event handler method. Next, I navigate to the child switch event handler method. Here, I check if all the child switches are on. If they are, set the isOn property of all apps to true. Otherwise, if all the child switches are off, set the isOn property of all apps to false. If neither condition is met, set the all apps allow indeterminate state properties to true. and is on to null. Please note that the indeterminate state only works if the allow indeterminate state property is set to true. Next, I navigate to the all app state change event handler method. First, check whether the new value from the event arguments is set to true or false. If it is, set the allow indeterminate state property of all apps to false. Then, check whether the new value from the event argument is not null. If it is, set all other switches on properties to a new value. Now you can see the all apps switch and all other switches are in the off state. When I toggle the switch on, all the child switches also turn on. If any of the child switches is in the off or on state, the all apps switch enters an indeterminate state. Next, I'll show you how to customize the appearance of the switch track based on its state using a style. First, add the content page resources property and the resource dictionary. Inside this dictionary, include a style instance and set its target type to switch. Within the style, add a setter instance to adjust the width request property to 120. Then, include another setter instance to set the visual state manager property. Next, add the visual state group list with a visual state group named common states to define visual states for on, off, and indeterminate. Add a visual state within the group for the on state. Inside the visual state, include a setter's list property and a setter instance, set its property to switch settings. Add a value object with an instance of the switch settings element. Within the switch settings instance, customize the track width request to 80. By default, it's set to 50. Track height request to 40. By default, it's set to 30. And set the track background and track stroke to appropriate colors. Similarly, add the visual states for off and indeterminate states and adjust the track background and track stroke properties based on their respective states. Before running the application, change the frame height to 250. See, in the switch control, the track size is increased and the track color is changed based on their state. Next, I'll show you how to customize the thumb color and size. By default, the thumb height and width are set to 14. To customize it, set the thumb width request and thumb height request to 24 for the on state. Then, to customize the thumb stroke and background color, set the thumb background and thumb stroke to the appropriate colors. Similarly, I customize the thumb sizes and colors for off and indeterminate states. You'll see the thumb sizes and colors change based on their state. Finally, I'll demonstrate how to customize the thumb icon. Before starting, I remove the thumb background, thumb stroke, track background, and track stroke properties for all states. Now, for example, I'll display a bell icon on the thumb based on its state. To customize the icon color, set the icon color property to green for the on state. And then set the custom path property to the appropriate value of the bell path. Similarly, I customize path and icon colors for off and indeterminate states. You can observe that the bell icon is displayed instead of the thumb position reflecting the state. In this video, I have shown you how to add a switch control to your .NET MAUI application. I demonstrated programmatically how a switch operates in its different states. I also showed how to customize the track color and size and the thumb color, size, and icon. To learn more about switch control features, check the documentation link in the description below. I have also included a link to check if you qualify for our community license, which gives you a free license key for our entire .NET MAUI control suite. If you found this video helpful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching.